like wood clamps. I guess you can't have too many compasses. If you still have one of these old contraptions from school, the first thing I suggest is throw that away. That's a piece of junk. You find these in drafting sets. These are nice instruments. These put a pencil and work very well. On a compass like this, if you're using it, every time you get done, release the tension on the spring. If you leave that wound up and that spring under tension, you probably will come to your toolbox and find that spring has broken. These are a Japanese compass, very handy little things. Sharp point, and you can use either a pencil lead here or a knife blade for cutting out gaskets. This is called a pocket compass. This is made by woodpeckers, CNC machined, and the pin that it pivots on stores up here so you don't lose it. And that's made for a mechanical pencil lead. John Hines' little compass, I made two versions of his. One will fit this mechanical pencil, and I made the other one to fit a regular pencil. This beam compass I made so it would use a ballpoint pen. Every time you get the ballpoint pen, it's a different size. It's hard to make anything that's standard for that. And that works quite well. You just loosen these up, slide that back and forth. Sometimes it works a little smoother than others. This is a nice beam compass that was a construction article in one of the wood magazines. I have not been able to find that article. I do not remember what magazine it was in. I'll give you some details and dimensions for making this. These were made by Roger Schroeder. Roger Schroeder was an avid modeler, miniature airplanes and model engines. This is a wood doll. Has a very sharp point and uses a number 11 X-Acto blade. He had these guards on here for obvious reasons. You use that for cutting out gaskets. He made this little gadget, and he had all these different blades you put on there for whatever size circle you were trying to cut for cutting gaskets for engines. And this one held a modified blade. It would slide back and forth, and he used that for cutting out gaskets. So you can use this idea and come up with your own design of a compass or a beam compass. I'm going to show you how this one went together. This beam compass was a construction article in one of the woodworking magazines. I have not been able to find that article. I don't remember which magazine. I do know that the people that were selling the hardware kit for this no longer sell those because I bought the last few pieces they had. This works. You loosen the thumb screw, you set this to whatever radius you want. Pencil is in this side. This works quite well until you get past the center, and then it's a little bit too heavy out here, so I would suggest making two different ones. This one is not quite 24 inches long, about the largest radius that this will produce is 22 inches. And that's really determined by the raw stock that's available for making these. This was originally supposed to be made using a brass rod or a brass tube. Good luck finding any of those that are straight. So this is actually a fiberglass rod that they sell for holding up reflectors for marking the edge of your driveway. They come in different colors. Use a heat gun and remove this reflective tape carefully. If you want to make a longer version, then obviously it'll take more than one piece of rod. Or you can make a long version and a short version by using two rods. Like Chinese marbles, color seems to determine the size of these. A 1/64 hole is a little bit snug on this, a little loose on that, and this one is 5/16 in diameter. This is a kit for making one of these. These are Bubenga. That's 6.5 inches long inch and a half wide, 3/4 inch thick. One of those is enough to make, certainly enough to make one of these, possibly not quite enough to make two. 6/32 socket head machine screw. That's 1 inch long. Thumb screw is 3/4 inch thread length. A metal threaded insert, which is 6/32, and a 1/8 inch brass rod. You cut the head off the socket head screw and make a nice point on that. That screws in here as your pivot. You have one thumb screw on the slider, and you have one to hold the pencil. Two metal threaded inserts are used on the slider, and one is inside here for this thumb screw. This end piece is pinned on both sides with the brass rod, and this is pinned on both sides with the brass rod. The brass rod only goes through the fiberglass and into the wood on the other side. It does not go all the way across. This end piece is 3/4 inch long. The slider is 7/8 inch long, and the pencil holder is 1 inch long. The through holes are all drilled 1964ths for the gold color rod. These holes on the side for the brass pin, I drilled those 7/64ths as a pilot hole, and then after I put the rod in, I drilled it for the 1/8 inch. The spacing center to center on these holes is 7/8 inch. This piece has not been drilled through for the metal insert or the thumb screw. There's a hole in this end, which is a 9/64ths. It goes all the way through. The pencil hole is 5/16ths. And then you back drill it. The 3/16ths, which was the right size for my metal insert, and that metal insert installs from this end, and it goes in, only goes in that deep. That's the depth for that 3/16ths hole. And then I drilled this a little bit bigger to clear that thread and to make it a little bit easier to install. And the hole on mine is 15/64ths. These holes for the brass pins were all drilled small to begin with as a pilot hole, just drilled into wood. I drilled these 7/64ths. Then after the rod was pushed in there, I probably put a drop of super glue on this side just to hold that in place. And you want to make sure when you put these two ends in here that's flat, it doesn't have a twist in it. And you can tell that by just sighting down through there. After the rods are in place, then I drilled this for the 1/8 brass pin. And used sharp pieces of that, pushed that in there, and put a drop of super glue on there. Then sand it and smooth everything up. And I just finished these with linseed oil. So using one of these shafts, that's 23 5/8, and that's about the longest that you can get out of one of these rods. If you use two rods, you can make it however long you want. I would suggest you make one about this long, and then make one that's about 12 inches. That would be a good combination. These rods are available at like Home Depot or Lowe's. They have a reflective tape on them. Some of them have a reflector on it. It's cheaper to buy these. Or you can use a piece of arrow shaft. Arrow shafting is very straight. The slider is drilled and the metal inserts installed, and then you cut it in half to obtain these two pieces. This is still 1964th hole, still 7/8 center to center spacing. These holes are 3/8 inch center to center. The one hole is a 9/64ths that went all the way through, and I back drilled it. Depends on how you want to do it. These are drilled 3/16ths. That was the right size hole for my threaded insert, and they only have to be deep enough for that insert to go in there and be flush. And this hole is smaller, and that's just enough to clear the threads on the thumb screw. You cut that in half. Your thumb screw is on there, and your sharpened machine screw goes into that piece. That should be enough information for you to be able to make one of these. Just watch the video again and take a few notes.